Okay, for today we've got three workouts.
I found CrossFit through a friend. So he showed me the main site and then I went onto that, and when I saw what it's all about, and then I got hooked onto that.
Now you're gonna slide down to your bottom of your knee.
I like to be first in a lot of things in my life. You know, to have the first CrossFit box in Africa was one of the things I wanted to achieve. I went over to Manchester, got certified, and started the first CrossFit box, and you know, just learned as we go along from HQ, and it was quite daunting at first.
So upper body nice and upright, feet underneath your hips, and that same position, push your hips back. So dip into your heels.
I had a Tae Bo studio. I was the first certified Tae Bo instructor in Africa. I changed over to CrossFit and I lost half the clientele. So, and those that stuck with me, they saw the benefits of CrossFit, and then the half that left eventually came back and they saw the difference in the people that stayed.
Nice work. Okay, set yourself up.
Donnie and Heather,
nice to meet you.
They are the original.
That's
CrossFit
what Dave was
box.
Saying.
Yeah.
Flagship.
What box is it?
CrossFit B4C.
B4C.
Yeah.
Welcome to Zule on an African winter day. Yes, tough. We live hard down here.
I've always been an athlete, you know, so first is quite a, you know, first in athletics, first rugby, you know, drill, peloton, you know, all of that stuff. You know, I like to push myself, you know, to places where I haven't been, and CrossFit allows me to do that. And, you know, there's so much to try to be first in, first muscle up, first handstand push up. So everything is foreign to me. It's a big challenge for me, and I love a challenge, yeah.
There's a push up. There's a sit-up, there's jumping jacks, and what was the other one, Jess? Squats. I am a teacher, and I was teaching previously, and I just saw through the years our kids were just getting more and more out of shape, more obese, more sort of health problems related to, you know, being inactive, and I just realized, I knew straight away that CrossFit was the answer.
It just came naturally. Natalie was a client of mine, and she certified, and that was her passion. It just rolled over into the CrossFit Kids. And also it was the first CrossFit Kids coach that was in Africa, so that was part of us.
Go! Ah, there you go. Good job. And one more. Well, when I did my certification, CrossFit Kids weren't traveling. You had to do it at HQ. So it was really expensive for any South Africans to go across and do the cert. But I think about a month ago, they came over and they did the first CrossFit Kids cert here in Africa. So now we've got quite a few more qualified trainers, which is great. Because now we can start building a community of CrossFit Kids.
The kids got their class and the mommy and daddy come to our class. Those kind of families that train together like that, they stay together. You know, they've got so much more to talk about when they go home. They interact more, that it helps them as a family as well. CrossFit is such an awesome sport.
Okay, and rest, guys. Okay, put the bean bags away, have a drink of water, and we're gonna come back. What I enjoy most is just seeing children change. So we get a lot of children come in here, they're out of shape, they're not confident, they've got no self-confidence in themselves. And they come to the CrossFit Kids and within a month or two, they're walking differently. They're more confident, they're speaking out in the group, they're making friends. So it's not so much the physical as the emotional and the confidence that you see growing.
Nice,
well done. Oh, go, pull me over.
I haven't met God, and I haven't gave my heart to Jesus and know what it's all about. I was addicted to cocaine, and I was in the bouncing industry. I had a bouncing company. You know, that world just swallowed me in. You know, start selling, start using, start messing around and all that stuff. So I got divorced from my wife. She left me, and you know, I lost everything in life. And you know, I start training again, and you know, everything just came back together. When I gave my heart to the Lord, I asked Charmaine to give me a second chance, and thank God she did. And I went off the rails for quite a bit. And then when I came back and gave my heart to the Lord, you know, and since then, you know, I realized that I can't do anything without Jesus Christ in my life. And I told myself, bodies for Christ, B4C, that's what it stands for. And I'm gonna give my body to God, and everything that I do, you know, must honor Him.
Mooi, Manny, home, Darcel.
Beautiful, beautiful.
He's helped me a lot with like little tips, little things that round your movements off quite well. That really, really, really helped a lot. The base was there, just a nice rounding off, all the way down, a little higher, smoother transitions, stuff like that. Really, really great guy, really great coach.
It's difficult to explain my emotions in a few words. It's just overwhelming for me, you know, and I can just see the sport just growing and growing and growing. There's a few things that obviously we have to work on, but you know, that's how it is.
I went to his gym in last year, beginning of last year, in November, 2 years ago, and just started all there. I started there, did my level one, started coaching, and been training myself ever since.
Everybody just wants to do it. It's so easy now to open up a box and you just got members automatically. We worked so hard to keep our members and to explain to them this is good for you, and they don't understand why do you have to be upside down and why do you have to jump on the box, and you know, they didn't understand that way of training. It was really hard for us in the beginning. To see where it's now, where we started from, it's so, I'm so excited to what it is and what it's going to be at a few years down the line.
Dan, yeah. Well done.